Hello. Thank you for being here. Yeah, my name is Marcella, and as you just said, I'm an architect. But I'm not just an architect, most of all, I'm an ocean lover. And as an ocean lover, I'm traveling the world a lot, and also love diving. So I love being in the sea, even I'm a little bit afraid of fish. So when I go diving, it's always like, yeah, it's nice to see them, but it's better when they are quite far away. And a couple of years ago, I had this one dive where I expected fish, but what I saw was not fish, but a lot of plastic around. And suddenly I realized that I actually have to be more afraid of all the plastic than of the fish. And I couldn't stop thinking about this topic, because it changed something in my mind. And when I was back home, I started to read newsletters and articles about that, because a couple of years ago, this topic was not as much as in the news as it is today. So I was quite shocked when I realized that there are 700 tons of plastic getting into our oceans every hour. And I asked myself, but what to do? We need to do something. We need to take action. We cannot just sit and wait until our whole planet is covered with plastic. And I realized that this problem is like not just in some diving spots, but it's like global. And that all the plastic, which is also in our rivers, sooner or later it's entering the oceans. And it's accumulating within these ocean gyres. And it's not staying as a whole bottle or held back, but during the time, because of erosion, sunlight, and waves, it's getting into smaller and smaller pieces. It's breaking down. And it's not floating in the ocean on the surface anymore, but it's accumulating in the first 30 to 50 meters. So you cannot just take a net and get it out of the water, because otherwise you would also take all the fish and all the plankton out of the water, which doesn't make any sense. So I started to do a lot of research, beginning at the development of the Earth and the oceans, about plastic production and, of course, about plastic consumption. Because plastic is a product which is quite new. We only have plastic since almost 100 years, but we got it to put our whole planet covered with plastic within hundreds of years. So this is quite bad. And then I had this idea to think about that I'm not the only person who tries to clean water. So I analyzed sewage plants, and within a sewage plant, you do have a sedimentation basin. The water is getting inside, it's getting calmed down, and the sediments are going to the ground. And the clean water is just getting further. What I did, I just flipped this principle upside down, and I developed this huge platform, which can be positioned within these ocean gyres to calm down the ocean currents, so the plastic particles, which do have a lower density than water, can just go up with their own density. And in the end of the platform, they're floating on the surface, so we can just skim them from the ocean surface. And the idea was not to burn this plastic, but to use it as a resource, because it is a resource, and to put it into energy and biodegradable plastics. And actually, this huge concept was just my master thesis in architecture. But a lot of people ask me, like, did you think about to realize it? To really clean the oceans? I was like, yeah, probably. But how can I prove it? I mean, I'm an architect, and I cannot do any calculations about currents and winds and stuff. So I was thinking about what to do. And I asked a lot of people. And what I got was a lot of headwind. I went to companies, to institutes, even to the EU in Brussels, and ask them, hey guys, I do have this idea, but I cannot prove it, so please could you help me? And they were all like, yeah, this is really cool, it's a really great idea. Probably it could save our planet, our oceans, but come back when you can prove it. Great, thank you. So what I did, I went in Aachen, like next door, to the Institute for Hydraulic Engineering, and asked them, so guys, I do have this idea on the one hand, but I have no idea how to prove it. And they said, yeah, we cannot do any, we don't have any fundings for that, but what we can do, we can make first calculations with our students. And a couple of months after that, they came back to me and said, yeah, we had to take a lot of assumptions, but the concept is actually feasible. And I was quite happy, and I was not alone in the boat anymore. I had some students and people working at the institute who wanted to join me for this project. And yeah, now we had this project. We had the first calculations, but how to start? So what can we do with it? And again, we got a lot of headwind because we wanted to save our oceans. And everybody was just saying, yeah, but you need like a business plan. You need to think about how to make as much money as possible. And who cares about our planet? Actually, we do. Because we only have this one planet. It's quite beautiful. And for us, it's really important because it's our home. And what we want to do is we want to save our planet. We don't want to care about earning as much money as possible, but we want to save our future. So what we did was not to found the biggest company ever, but we founded an NGO. In the beginning, we didn't have enough people even to found an NGO, because you need 7. We were only 5, so we needed to hire some friends and colleagues to get at least these 7. And yeah, we were quite lucky, because now we had an official organization standing behind our idea, our project. And yeah, we were asking ourselves, so how to go on? No money, not enough people, so what to do? First of all, we focused on 2 points. We had like 2 targets, 2 goals. The first one is, and it's still, to take this idea and to put it into a feasible technology. Because, of course, we cannot just build this ocean monster directly, but what we want to do is to build a prototype which we can put into river and river mouths, to get the plastic out of the water before it's entering the oceans. And on the other hand, we need to take care about this plastic consumption, because this is a really, really stupid thing. We humans use a material, for example, a plastic bag. It's made for last for 450 years, at least, and then it's still not away. And we use it for 10 minutes. Great. Congratulations, humans. This is absolutely stupid, and we do it every day. Everybody of us is using single-use plastic all day long for a coffee-to-go cup, for bags, for everything. Everything is covered with plastic. And all of the plastic which was ever produced, half of it was produced within the last 10 years. So when we think about the next 10 years, yeah, you can imagine how our planet is going to look like in 10 years. So what we need to do and what we want to do is to stop this stupid plastic consumption. Because plastic is not a stupid product, definitely not. It's, in some ways, it's the best thing we can use. But we need to use it in an intelligent way for products which are made out of plastic, which is the best way to use it. So this was it. And we know that it's not a local problem, but it's really, really global. It's really huge. And when we want to do it, we need to raise awareness all over the planet. And actually, our NGO is quite young. We are like 1.5 years old. But last year, we raised a lot of attention. I started alone, but within the last 2 years, we got awards, we got invitations for presentations. Last year was a couple of times in India, for example. And we are getting further. And even our team is rising a lot. Now we are working with almost 40 people on this project. We have almost 400 members. And we are doing this all as volunteers. And this is a huge problem because we want to go on, but we don't have the money for that. So what we're now going to do is to do crowdfunding, to start getting research funds, to start looking for partner sponsors to realize this project. Because finally, it's about money, but it's not about the money to buy the biggest house or to buy the fastest car, but to save our future. And the other point is that we really need to raise awareness, because a lot of people don't even know about their plastic behavior. And this is why we do have a short film, which I would like to share with you, which tells a little story why we all need to do this.
I had this dream again. Unbelievable deepness. Infinite blue. So impressive and fascinating. Just for a brief moment, I'm feeling free. A dream so vivid, the waking seems like the illusion, and my dream the reality. Then I open my eyes and and realize that the sea of my dreams doesn't exist anymore. We are witnesses of a plastic ocean. In my dreams, I see hope. Hope for a generation that will be wiser, will be stronger, will be more respectful. Please, keep this dream alive.
Ser fantástico.
Will you? Yeah, and that's us. We are this new generation. We are wiser because we know what plastic is doing to our environment, to our planet. We are stronger because we do have the boldness to take action now. And we are more respectful because we know that we only have this one planet and it's definitely worth saving it. Often I get asked, hey, but there are other projects working on this topic. What do you think about your competitors? Hey, they are no competitors, not at all. They are doing the same I'm doing. They love the ocean the way I do, and they are heroes, no competitors, because actually there is so much plastic in the ocean, it's enough for all of us. And unfortunately, and we need to need more people taking action and work on this topic. So there is, in these times, on this topic, there is no space and no time for competition. We need to do that together. We cannot fight against each other. We need to fight together for this planet, for our future. And yeah, we need to do it now. And our generation, and we are this new generation, we are the future of our planet. We need to work together. And don't wait for others doing this. Let's be those others. Let's be the eco-warriors. Let's be the ones saving our oceans. And most of all, let's do this together. We cannot do this alone. And let's be the wave that saves our oceans. Thank you.